Hello everyone, and in this video we are going to see about the DSBSC wave, that is double sideband suppressed carrier wave generation. And if you notice here, it can be generated simply by multiplying the message signal and the carrier signal. So one multiplier is fairly enough to generate the DSBSC wave. And why the name DSBSC is obtained, you can see in the video, or by the end of this video you will be get cleared why it is called as double sideband suppressed carrier wave. And I will explain this after seeing the spectrum so that you will be get more cleared. So let's get started with this. So here is my front panel. So I am going to take as usually a while loop. So here is my while loop, and I'm going to create the control for this, that is loop control. And now I am going to place a message signal, that is simulate signal block. And as this is the message signal, let me take 100 hertz, and the amplitude I will place it as 1, and the samples are 1 lakh samples, and let me leave it as sine as it is taking some time, which is not much important to spend on that. So let me take another simulate signal block, and as this is the carrier, so let me take the frequency as 1000, and the amplitude I will place the same. And here you can change the phase shift or no problem, that is not an issue. Or let me change this to 90 degrees, so that message is here also message is a single tone modulated wave, so that you will observe the spectrum just after the carrier, that is FC. And if you take a multi-tone wave, then you will see at FC plus FM and FC plus 2 FM and FC plus 3 FM, and similarly FC minus FM, FC minus 2 FM, so on it will repeat. And now let me take a multiplier, and so that here I am going to multiply the both message and carrier simply, and here I am going to see the output, create graph indicator. And if you want to see how the message and carrier waveforms, you can create two more graph indicators, that's not an issue. So let me create one more graph indicator. So here I am going to place a spectrum also, a waveform measure, that is spectral, so that you can see how the spectrum is different from amplitude modulation wave and the DSBSC wave, so that it will get more cleared if you place a spectrum analyzer. So let me take a graph indicator, create graph indicator. So simply here also, if you multiply with the carrier, then the demodulation will be completed. So let me, as cos square theta is 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2, if you pass that through a low pass filter, you will get the input signal that we have given, that is the message signal. We can recover that. As the connection is not correct, here it is giving into mark, so you can take this as an experience that if you should connect it properly, then the color will get highlighted. So here I will give to my carrier. So now I have to pass this through the low pass filter. So I will take one low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of higher cutoff frequency of 100. As the message signal frequency is 100, the cutoff frequency 100 is fairly enough. And here I am going to place one more graph indicator. So that's all, these are the connections for the DSBSC wave. So let us see how it will appear. So I am going to place them side by side spaciously as the panel. So now let me run this. So now you can see, let me elaborate this, 0.01, so, or let me take it as 0.05 so that it will be more clear. No, 0.02, the scaling plays a vital role to study it clearly. And this is our demodulated wave. And let me place this as 0.01 and here also let me place 0.01 and here also 0.01. Let me change the here also, as it center frequency or carrier frequency is 1000, so 2000 is fairly enough. So now why it is called as the suppressed carrier means you have to elaborate this spectrum analyzer. Let me take a more space to explain this. So you can simply or see clearly, you can see that at FC there is no no energy is present at the carrier, and the equation also is simply multiplied message into carrier, whereas compared to the amplitude modulation we have the obtained equation is carrier plus message into carrier. So here the carrier term is completely gone. It means that pure carrier, we are neglecting the pure carrier energy, so that here the energy or the spectrum near the carrier, that is 1000 hertz, is absent and the sidebands are there. So it is called as a double sideband and the suppressed carrier wave. And similarly, in the next video you can see that a single sideband suppressed carrier wave, so that you can suppress the upper sideband or the lower sideband along with the carrier, so that it is more efficient in terms of energy saving. But the circuit is quite complex, so we don't prefer that much. So I think you all guys enjoyed this video a lot, and that's all for this video, and see you in the next one.